Did you know there's a growing threat that could kill 10 million people per year by 2050? Well, that's a huge problem. If you think that's interesting, I think you should see this video. Hi, my name is Miguel and I'm a postdoctoral researcher at APC Microbiome at University College Cork. Antibiotics are medicines used to treat and prevent microbial infections. So, antibiotic resistance occurs when microorganisms change in response to the use of these medicines, becoming more or fully resistant to them, especially when they are used inappropriately. According to the World Health Organization, and I'm quoting here, antibiotic resistance is rising to dangerously high levels all around the world. New resistance mechanisms are emerging and spreading globally, threatening our ability to treat common infectious diseases. Infections such as pneumonia, tuberculosis, gonorrhea, and also life-threatening fungal infections such as candidiasis are becoming harder or impossible to treat as antibiotics become less and less effective. However, not everything is bad news. Researchers in many countries are looking for novel and also pretty cool alternatives to traditional antibiotics, including us. Our research at APC Microbiome focuses on the development and design of novel antimicrobial peptides. These are molecules composed of amino acids, which have antibiotic activity. In these images, we can see how our peptides can kill this dense biofilm of Candida albicans and turn it into this. For now, we are designing peptides for the treatment of fungal infections, such as vaginal candidiasis. But we have some evidence pointing that our peptides could be used to treat other infections as well. There are still many studies to be done, but our final goal is to put these peptides to reach of society. It's really fascinating how nature can be a huge source of tools to fight the antimicrobial resistance and improve our life quality. Antimicrobial peptides is one of many fronts that science has taken to tackle down this global threat. However, there are others too, such as vaccines, phage therapy, and rapid diagnostics, just to mention a few. So now that you know more about antibiotic resistance, let's fight it together. Use good practices of sanitation and hygiene, and if you're feeling sick, don't self-medicate and always go to your GP. Thank you for watching this video, and if you want to know more about our research, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Bye!